Let's practice finding the slope of the tangent line. So the directions here say to find the slope of the tangent line to f of x equals x cubed minus 2x plus 1 at the point x equals 2. And I've pasted down below the formula for the slope of the tangent line so that we have that to reference. Okay, so let's just dive right into the problem. So the definition here says that the slope of the tangent line at the point x equals a equals the limit as h goes to 0 of f of a plus h minus f of a all over h. So here, our a equals 2. So then the slope of the tangent line in this case is going to equal the limit as h goes to 0 of f of 2 plus h minus f of 2 all over h. Okay, so there's several pieces that go into this formula. One of them is this f of 2 plus h piece. Now, this is going to happen pretty often when you're calculating these kind of problems. The f of 2 plus h, or f of whatever plus h piece, is often kind of messy. So you may want to actually calculate that out to the side and then bring it back in at the end, just to avoid a lot of messiness in your formula. So that's what I'm going to do here. Out to the side, I'm going to work out what f of 2 plus h is. So to find f of 2 plus h, I simply plug in the quantity 2 plus h for x in my function. So that's going to look like this. 2 plus h quantity cubed, so I just plugged it right in for the x, minus 2 times the quantity 2 plus h plus 1. Okay, so now I just have to use algebra to work all of this out. Okay, so 2 plus h cubed, that's going to be 2 plus h times 2 plus h times 2 plus h. And then we're going to have minus 2 times 2 plus h plus 1. Okay, so cubing something's a little tedious, but probably the best way to do it is start by just doing two pieces at once. So in other words, I'm going to FOIL these first two factors. And if I do that, I'm going to get 4 plus 2h plus 2h, so that's 4h, plus h squared. And all of that is times this other factor of 2 plus h. Okay, minus. Well, I can go ahead and work out what this is. If I distribute the 2, that's going to give me 4 plus 2h. And then I have plus 1. Okay, so now I have a quadratic times this 2 plus h factor. So remember how to work with that. What I'm going to do is I'm going to first multiply the 2 by every term in this first set of parentheses. And then I'm going to multiply the h by every term in the first set of parentheses. So that's going to look like this. So for the 2, okay, so I'm distributing the 2 to each term like this. So that's going to give me 8 plus 8h plus 2h squared plus, and now I'm going to do the same thing with the h. I'm going to distribute the h to each term in the parentheses. So that's going to give me plus 4h plus 4h squared plus h cubed. Okay. And then I still have all these other terms. So minus the quantity 4 plus 2h plus 1. Okay, now what we can do, so let me rewrite these first pieces. 8 plus 8h plus 2h squared plus 4h plus 4h squared plus h cubed. Now I'm going to distribute the subtraction sign to both terms within the parentheses. So minus 4 minus 2h plus 1. Okay, so now that everything's all multiplied out, distributed, we can go ahead and combine terms. So you might have your own method for doing that. The way I usually like to approach it is start with the highest powered term and then kind of go down the line. So in other words, I would start with h cubed, and I would look for all the h cubed terms. Here there's only one, just h cubed, and then I cross that out up here so I can keep track of it. And then I look for all my h squared terms. So I've got a 2h squared and a 4h squared, so that's plus 6h squared. Cross those out. And then my h terms, so I've got an 8h, a 4h, and a 2h. So 8 plus 4 is 12, minus 2 is 10, so plus 10h. And then I've got my constants, so 8 minus 4 plus 1, so that's 5. All right, so now we've done the messiest part of this problem. While we're over here working on the side, let's also just go ahead and calculate f of 2. So here I'm just plugging in 2 to my function, which was x cubed minus 2x plus 1. So that's 2 cubed minus 2 times 2 plus 1. So that's 8 minus 4 plus 1, which gives us 5 again. Okay, so here are my two important pieces. Now that I have all that messy algebra worked out, I'm going to come back to my tangent, slope of tangent line formula and plug in those pieces. Okay, so the slope of the tangent line equals the limit as h goes to 0. So for f of 2 plus h, I have calculated that to be h cubed plus 6h squared plus 10h plus 5 minus f of 2, which is 5, all over h. Okay, so I see that in the top I've got 5 minus 5, so those go away. So now I have the limit as h goes to 0 of h cubed plus 6h squared plus 10h all over h. Okay, so now at this point, if we were just to plug in h equals 0 to this formula, we would get 0 over 0. And that's always going to be the case when you do these slope of tangent line problems. So you're going to have to do some sort of algebra to get this to simplify. Now, in this case, I've got a rational function, and it's really easy in this case just to get rid of a factor of h. So let me show you what I mean. In the top, I can factor out an h out of every term. So that would be h times the quantity h squared plus 6h plus 10, and that's all over h. So now I can more clearly see that I have a factor of h in the top and a factor of h in the bottom, and I'm going to cancel those out. And this is equivalent, then, to the limit as h goes to 0 of h squared plus 6h plus 10. Okay, so now I'm left with a continuous function, just a polynomial here. So to evaluate the limit, I simply plug in. So if I plug in 0 here to this formula, I'm going to end up with 10. So 10 is my final answer. 10 is the slope of the tangent line at x equals 2 to this polynomial.